for the Christian part of me. Not for the Christ, but for the Christian, I am sorry. For when I look at the book and look at my life, when I look at the Christ and look at the church, the two are as black and white. So for the way I have silenced you with words I thought were the only true, for every preacher that has yelled at you, every Bible that's been quoted at you, every megaphone that has damned you, every friend that has judged you, every parent that has guilted you, I am sorry. For my brothers who say that God hates fags, oh, how I wish they were not my brothers. Sometimes it is easier to love your enemies than your kin. So to every boy who sliced wrists because he didn't fit within, no matter how much he pushed and pulled, did not fit in his skin, was told he was sin, that demons lurked within, I am sorry. You are not broken because you are gay. We are all broken because we are human, because we treat each other this way, the way we judge by the words that are spoken, by the burqa you were cloaked in, by the crystals you believed in, by the gender you were born in. So to every person I did not converse with, but tried to convert instead, I'm sorry for the way that I couldn't see past these glasses. Sorry for the way I thought my pastor spoke the absolute truth. Didn't know he was broken just like the rest of us. Thought he was the best of us. For the arrogance I thought was confidence, when I thought I was right and you were wrong. We were good and you were bad. We were light and you were dark. I took a pen, drew a line before us, took some bricks, built a wall between us, stood on the pedestal, crafted the cross into a pulpit and yelled at you from within it, I am sorry. And to the lady who was beaten as I sang songs within my church, to the addict who overdosed as I dine with Christian friends, to the beggar who needs money as my money built church buildings, to the boat person arriving on these shores of hope and hopelessness, to the teenager who is pregnant with abortion as an option, I am sorry we have yelled at you, made you feel so alone. We should have put an arm around you and walked with you home, whether it was a pram you pushed before you that day or just the will to keep on walking. So for the wars that were fought in the name of the Christ, and the swords that were swung in the name of his love, the bombs that exploded, the bullets sang hymns, the tanks marched on like good Christian soldiers who prayed every day for their God to be with them, as their brothers they fought and their sisters they shot, their sons in the flame, did we not recognize they all prayed the same, for this God to be with them, for this God to protect? Oh, how this God must have wept, if only we'd listened to the prayer of the other. If only we'd seen that he was our brother, whether on his knees with his hands to the east, whether yarmulke wearing or burqa bearing, whether sitting beneath the Bodhi tree or kissing the feet of some saint celebrity, we lifted the rifle to shoot the enemy, the cross-bearing flag to show our allegiance to be. We did not hear the sound whispered from the cross that day. Forgive them, Father, for they know not what they do. We forgot that the Christ we claimed to follow walked the talk of non-violence, ate the stale bread of silence, stood up against the systems of military might, of fear and oppression, of bigoted aggression. This is my confession. So with every part of me, I would keep following this Jesus and the life that he lived and the love that he gives. Yet every part of me, because of this history, would deny that I am a Christian, to put high walls between these brothers and I. But who am I to be bigoted about the bigoted? And who am I to condemn those who condemn if I keep the name Christian? Perhaps I can speak to them, remind them of this Jesus, of Mother T and Martin King, of Mandela and Tutu, of that great man from Assisi. Yes, there is still some pride left in my ancestry. And for all else, I say, I am sorry. I am sorry.